On the beds of America's waterways are small species of aquatic life that support a balanced food chain and improve water quality. They are freshwater mussels, and to demonstrate their powers, Rachel of the Harrison Lake Fish Hatchery set up a display for us.
So it's officially been 3 hours now since Rachel put the freshwater mussels in these tanks. Same water sample, but I mean, look how much more clear that is. It's incredible.
So freshwater mussels are in a lot of people's backyards. They're filtering our rivers. As the rivers flow downstream into the ocean, the marine bivalves are filtering the ocean. So they're really nature's river water filters.
Here at Harrison Lake National Fish Hatchery, we produce 12 to 14 species of freshwater mussel. And over a period of about 2 years of growing them, eventually we end up releasing them back into rivers around Virginia. We are propagating freshwater mussels because they are so endangered. Greater than 70% of them are threatened in some manner. People don't realize, like in Virginia, we have over 70 species of freshwater mussel, and people may have never heard of them. So we really want to keep healthy populations and keep diversity, which is important.
None of the species propagated here are the notorious zebra mussels, which have become invasive in North America and in many other countries.
They were only 12 millimeters when they went in here, and so we can really grow mussels out to a large size in these baskets.
So freshwater mussels, they filter food in order to eat. All the food that they don't eat, they discard and they package it up. And it's actually something that aquatic insects can eat. And then from there, you know, the small fish eating aquatic insects and so on.
They need a host fish to complete their life cycle. They have all of these ways that they try to attract the host fish to them because they need the host fish to complete their life cycle.
The eastern pond mussel. They have a pretty neat lure. It's like little white, like waving little fingers kind of to lure the fish in. So freshwater mussels have a complex life cycle, which makes them very vulnerable to changes in the environment. And they're also sessile, so they can't move. Maybe they can move 5 or 6 feet. So if you are going to see changes in the environment, they aren't able to get away from those changes like fish are.
Some causes of declines in mussel populations can be due to dams that prevents host fish and mussels from moving up or down a river, factories that are discharging directly into streams, increases in sedimentation. I mean, all populations go through are cyclical. So you have increases and then you have declines, and you have increases and declines. And so that certainly happens with freshwater mussels too. I think we're moving out of the realm of natural since 72% of them are imperiled.
According to multiple studies, our warming climate and changes in precipitation may also be contributing to these population declines.
They've been in these systems probably for most of that year, so as they graduate from those 5-gallon buckets up to the bigger chambers that you saw inside, and now they've made it into here, and they're constantly getting fresh pond water from our ponds recirculating, so they've always got a lot of food available to them, and they can really put on some size here.
My hope for the future of freshwater mussel conservation is that we don't lose any more species. There's lots of good things that they're doing for our rivers, so we need to improve the populations that we have, improve the habitat, and if we can't do that, then use propagation as a tool. I hope that I don't have a job one day.
But I mean, look how much more clear that is. It's incredible. In fact, it might just be clean enough to drink.